were buried with him in baptism, in which you were also raised with him.
And if you listen to this gospel carefully, you got a sense in which the disciples are...
There were many unforgettable adventures on this mission trip.
Today, I am a horse. Fiddler on the Roof begins with Tevye crying out, "Today, I am a horse." And then he goes on to say, "Dear God, did you have to make my horse lame tonight on the Sabbath?" And he goes on to complain. If you watch that play, Fiddler on the Roof, if you've ever seen it, what you see with Tevye is this incredible relationship with God. The whole dialogue is almost all prayer. He begins certainly by complaining, but he also finds himself struggling. Every once in a while, you get a little bit of his humor as he prays to God and says, "You know, I wouldn't mind if I was a rich man. Besides, I spent all my day praying and reading a good book." But then you find out he finds himself going on and he's praying for how to deal with his daughters and what's going to happen to them. And as he struggles with each of them stretching his life and pulling his traditions in different directions, you see, really, he's saying, "Lord, help me, sustain me on the journey of life." And then as he's thrown out of his village, he believes that God is with them on the journey, helping them to make sense of life. And whenever I read that passage from Genesis that we heard today, I find myself thinking, this is really what it's about, isn't it? This whole sense of a dialogue with God. And can we have that kind of conversation with God where you're just free enough to say, "Please, help me understand." In that little dialogue between Abraham and God, there's a lot going on, and too much really even to explain here, because when you think about it, it's not just that it's haggling, and you get that sense that he's trying to get a better price on his RV, but you have that real sense that he's haggling in a way that he says, "You know, I have to understand here. I have to understand your justice in the face of mercy. And what are we going to do? And how can we respond? And can a few people be the source of salvation for the many? At what point, Lord, can people's image and response to you change the world?" It's a dialogue of struggle and hope and life. But there's nothing like the gospel for helping bring us to the point. And if you listen to this gospel carefully, you got a sense in which the disciples are watching Jesus pray and they're saying, "We want that. We want to be able to pray the way you pray. Tell us and teach us how to pray. Teach us how to be a people of prayer. Teach us what it means to pray." And Jesus says, "Well, pray this way." And he gives them some words. But as you listen to the words, you say, "Well, they're words we know. That we learned those as kids. You know, Father, you are holy. May your name always be holy. May your will be done on earth. And we pray that you forgive us because we are struggling to forgive others and keep us from final struggles. But through it all, give us today the bread of tomorrow. Give us now the bread that sustains us." And so we pray that prayer. We pray it every day. We pray it and we say, "Yes, Lord, this is what it means." But you know, the problem with prayers like that are memorized, and especially like we're going to say it in a few minutes here at liturgy, is that we'll rush through that, right? We just kind of, "Oh," because it's by rote and you know it and it's ingrained in your memories and you say, "Well, you know, okay." How do we really pray? How do we really allow ourselves to give ourselves over to relationship with God? And that's really the struggle. And Jesus goes on to say, "Well, I want you to persist in prayer. I don't want you to give up. I want you to pray as people who trust. I want you to pray as people who are open. Ask." Ask and you will receive. Knock and it will be. You know, there's that sense of which, oh, I don't want to pray for that. You know, I don't want to try. That whole sense of allowing yourself to pray and be changed by the prayer.